motherfuckers. This is me. Wait. Got the beer. All good. So, I thought I'd just do a really quick introductory video, I suppose, or a preface to the other video, which will be the suspension video. So tomorrow, well, the objective is tomorrow, provided the wife doesn't have better ideas. The plan is to actually remove half shafts, axles, I don't care what you call them, they're coming out. And to do that, I'm going to have to pull a fair bit of the aftermarket stuff out to make it all happen. So I thought, well, it's a good time where I can get good camera angles and all that sort of stuff, and just maybe a bit of an insight into what's what, how it works, why it works, the how and why being the important part. And I thought I'd like to spend a bit of time talking about them tomorrow in that video, and less time talking about some other bullshit like the NVH and all the associated rubbish that goes with it. So the purpose of this video is to discuss that part of it. So we've seen all kinds of claims. I mean, most of us, when we're making these changes, are worried about wheel hop. That's the predominant theme that seems to just keep popping up time and time again. Everyone's worried about wheel hop, and it's a valid claim. It's a valid concern. It's reasonable. Wheel hop will eventually, potentially, will break your axles faster than any amount of power will. So keep that in mind. But yeah. So the purpose of this video was to just be more clear on where we're going with it, which is that my car has substantial NVH, mostly the N, it's just noise. It doesn't vibrate, it's not harsh, it's just noise. And it's not even clunks and bangs, it's just a road noise, really. That's what it comes down to, road noise. On nice, smooth bitumen, it's quite livable. Put on some coarse chip bitumen and the shit. My car is more race car than James Judd's car is a fucking Shelby. I'll give you the red hot tip. James, you're full of shit, cunt. So, with that in mind, I thought, yeah, it was worthwhile having that discussion about the NVH. If you go and put Heim joints and solid bushings and shit in your car, it's going to matter. It will. I don't care what claims all the manufacturers and shit make. If you put parts in isolation, as in if you just do vertical links or you just do the cradle lockout or whatever, you probably won't notice it. But if you put the BMR cradle lockout and lower control arm, you know, Heim joints in the front there, if you then back that up with fucking tow rods that have got spherical bushings either end, and then so on and so forth, it's going to make noise. So I was like, get that off the bat. I didn't really want to spend too much time discussing that part of the equation. You need to make a decision for yourself about which way you want your car to go. Do you want a boulevard cruiser? Do you want a race car? Are you happy with something in the middle of all that? And that's really what it's all about. It's what you're comfortable with and getting to that point. The parts are there. The solutions are there. Can you live with them? That's what I'm talking about. So, cheers.